Here's the reality. I think one of the greatest disservices to kind of the economy is that Silicon Valley, where, I mean, I spent years there, right? It's just gotten so out of touch with the realities of what people are dealing with that you have billions of dollars being invested in the technology companies, right? And billions and billions of dollars being invested in things like crypto kitties or like some new currency on some blockchain, AI, whatever. Like, nobody needs, I promise you, in the rest of the country, another app that you pay $10 for to get a $6 burrito delivered to your apartment.
Yes.
Okay? That is just not what we need. But if you start to put some of that creativity into fixing things, you can start to rebuild these sectors to work for our generation. Right.
Why do you think it is that they are so focused on solving problems we don't actually have?
Because these are ironically, these are the biggest markets in the world, but they're so foreign to a world that's only thought software and fun and gimmicks and all this stuff, right? But at the same time, there are really simple ways that we can fix this problem, and that's kind of why I'm here today, right? So I'll give you an example. Remember, 40% of millennials have zero savings, okay? How many of you guys rent? Do you rent? Okay, do you guys all rent? In order to rent an apartment today, it's first month rent, last month rent, security deposit, your fucking firstborn child. Like, it's like, I mean, it's unbelievable. Like, you can't, like, just to be able to rent, you have to have so much savings. And what's happened now, by the way, as a result of that, almost 30% of people between the ages of 25 and 30 have had to move back in with their parent or grandparent. Think about that. In our generation, one in three almost people have now moved back in with a family member. That's outrageous. Right? And so we looked at this problem and said, okay, how do we fix it? Right? And if you think about it, like the security deposit, which is thousands of dollars, which is more than people have savings, doesn't actually do anything. It just sits there, sits in an escrow account. And by the way, by law, your landlord can't touch it, unless they're skeezy, which, you know, maybe they do. You can't use it. And by the way, you may not even get it back. Right? So we looked at that and said, this just makes no sense. And the first thing we did 2 years ago is we started an insurance company called Rhino, right? And it's so simple, and this is why I get frustrated that the Valley is not putting more time on these problems, because such a simple fix. We said security deposits are basically insurance. What if you could just pay $5 a month, just like you do for renter's insurance, right? We'll insure the landlord for you, and you get to keep your money. Yeah. That's simple. So we launched it. And in the first 6 months, we gave $10 million of savings back to renters in New York.